A transformer is a device that transfers electrical energy from one circuit to another using magnetic fields. Without any physical connection and without changing the frequency of the power, think of it as a bridge that changes the height of electricity's pressure, its voltage, so it can travel safely and efficiently. It works using the principle of electromagnetic induction. Let's break it down. Electromagnetic induction means producing voltage or current in a wire when the magnetic field around it changes. If you move a magnet through a coil or move the coil around a magnet, the magnetic field changes. That change induces a current. This is how generators work. But there's another way. If you send alternating current, AC, through a coil, it creates a changing magnetic field, even though nothing is moving. That changing field can also induce voltage in a nearby coil. This is how transformers work. So whether it's a moving magnet or alternating current, if the magnetic field changes, voltage is induced. That's electromagnetic induction. When electricity flows in the primary coil, it creates a changing magnetic field. This magnetic field passes through the core and cuts through the secondary coil, creating electricity there too. This is described by Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, which states that a voltage is induced in a coil when it's exposed to a changing magnetic field. The voltage and current in a transformer are controlled by the number of turns of wire in each coil. If the secondary coil has more turns than the primary, it increases voltage. That's a step-up transformer. If it has fewer, it reduces voltage, a step-down transformer. V1 over V2 equals N, 1 over N2 equals I2 over I1. This means voltage is proportional to the number of coil turns. If voltage goes up, current goes down and vice versa. The power ideally stays the same. The core of a transformer is made of special steel, cold-rolled grain-oriented, or CRJ, and is built in thin layers or laminations to reduce energy loss. This design helps focus the magnetic field while reducing heating from unwanted currents. Laminations break up the flow of wasteful electric currents inside the metal. Some transformers, especially those used in sound systems and sensitive electronics, use a different design called the toroidal transformer. Instead of the traditional square or rectangular core, a toroidal transformer uses a donut-shaped metal core, often made from silicon steel or ferrite. This closed-loop shape keeps the magnetic field tightly confined, which significantly reduces magnetic leakage and electromagnetic interference. It keeps energy tight and clean, which is why it's perfect for audio equipment. Toroidal transformers are also more efficient at reducing core losses. Lower eddy currents due to continuous magnetic flow. Less stray magnetic field, so nearby electronics stay safe. That solid ring of metal allows a continuous, unbroken path for magnetic flux, reducing reluctance, the magnetic equivalent of resistance, and improving energy transfer. The result? Less hum, more clarity, and a compact build ideal for modern systems. Even though transformers are efficient, often up to 99% docile, some energy is still lost. Losses come in two forms. Iron losses in the core. Hysteresis loss from the magnetic field changing directions. Eddy currents are these tiny circulating currents that produce heat. It's fascinating how something so small can generate such warmth. Copper losses in the windings, well, they're due to the resistance in the wire. This resistance turns electricity into heat, much like when your phone charger gets warm after a while. Now, to manage all that heat, transformers employ air or oil cooling. You'll often see labels like Onan or Onaf, which describe the cooling methods they use. Onan means the transformer cools itself naturally using oil and air. ONF adds fans to blow air and speed up cooling. Larger transformers may even use water to keep temperatures down.